What's up, everybody? This is Eric the Tech Preacher. So you got this shiny new device, your Galaxy Z Fold 2, and you want to make the best out of it. This device is a productivity beast. You can game on it. You can work and play and everything in between. I'm going to give you 10 tips and tricks on how to make this device better, baby. So sit back and relax and get your popcorn ready and follow me on this journey. Let's go. What's up, guys? This is Eric back with another video. So let me give you 10 tips and tricks that might help you make the best out of the beautiful device that you just got. Let's get into it. I don't want to waste no time. So let's go. The first thing you need to do when you get this device is change the keyboard. Man, the Samsung keyboard on this phone is terrible. I mean, when you got it open and you're doing some typing, it got that split keyboard. Man, I don't like that. Download Gboard or your favorite keyboard from the Google Play Store and install it on this device. I have Gboard. Gboard is very good, especially if you do a lot of typing. And let me show you. For example, just say you want to type a long document and you see the keyboard here, and this is Gboard right here. They got a lot of unique features that Gboard bring to the table, and you could type really good with that long keyboard instead of having that split keyboard, and it works very well. And it have predictive text. It will learn your ways and it will kind of predict your next word, which is great. So giving the prime example here, I got OneNote open. This is a test, and I'm gonna tell you, it works great and it learns all your ways. And not only that, but when you flip it this way, right, you flip it this way, and now when you open it up, now you have that full keyboard and it works great. Now look at that. Now you could get a lot of work done. You got a keyboard from edge to edge, and you don't have to deal with all that split keyboard and stuff like that. Even with the front display, it works very well. So download a good keyboard, and I like Gboard. Gboard works great for me. Not only that, but you can do all your swipe, so it works great. So download a keyboard. That's the first thing. The second thing that I believe you need to do is turn off the gestures. Now, as you can see, I don't have no buttons down here. And the reason why, because I want to get the fullest of the display that I can. So swipe gestures is something that you can, it works very well, because all you gotta do is swipe up to get to your recent apps and swipe up to get to your home screen. To get to that, you have to go to your settings. The easy way to get to your gestures is to search for buttons. And when you search for buttons, it's going to bring you to your navigation, and boom, there it is. And you have an option to either go to your buttons or your swipe gestures, but at boot, it's going to have your buttons. All right, so next on the list is that this device has a big display. It has a 120 hertz display. Now on the front of the device, the display on there is only 60 hertz, but when you open it up, it's locked at 120 hertz, but it's adaptive to try to save battery life. But if you're running into battery issues, you could always turn this device straight to 60 hertz, especially if you use the front display a lot. When you open it up, sometimes you want to get that good battery life, dropping this device down to 60 hertz works. So go into settings and you want to go into display. You go into motion smoothness and you have an option. You got adaptive refresh rate, or you can go to standard. And it tells you right here in the description, standard will give you long battery life, but it will keep you at 60 hertz. So your refresh rate will be at 60 hertz. And again, that will save you battery life. Me personally, I would say keep it at 120 hertz, but if you want to save some battery, put it on standard. So another tip that I believe is a must is to put this device in landscape mode. Out of the box, it's locked at portrait mode. So when you turn the device this way, it's going to be locked on portrait mode, but I like this in landscape. Can you see how you get the full potential of the display? That's something that if you're going to use a display this big, you should be able to rotate it from portrait to landscape. And but right now, the device out of the box is locked to portrait. So what you got to do, again, go to your settings, go to your display, and you want to scroll down and you want to go to home screen. All right, so again, and at default, the rotating to landscape mode is toggled off. You want to toggle that on so you can get the landscape mode out of your device. So basically, that's what you want to do. You want to go to your home screen and you want to toggle rotate to landscape mode. Now, when you toggle that on, you have to swipe down and make sure that your rotation is not locked. All right, so make sure your rotation is not locked for this to work, and it's dope. So anytime you want to use a device more like a PC or something like that, use it like this, and rotate to landscape is really good. So the next thing on the list is adaptive brightness. Oh my God, this drives me nuts. Out of the box, the device will change the brightness of your display. So if you go into a sunny area, or if you go into a dark area, or if you're just looking at your device, sometimes you see flickering. The device flickering, and that drives me nuts every time I look at my phone and I look at it, and 1 minute the brightness is too bright, the next minute it's too dark. Turn that off. By doing that, you go to, you scroll down and you click on the arrow down and you see what's called adaptive brightness. And what you want to do, just set your brightness to what you like and turn it off. Turn off adaptive brightness, because that sucks. I don't like the way a lot of devices do when they come down to adaptive brightness. Turn that off. So the next tip is to make your device faster. Sometimes when you get it out of the box, you got these animations in Android core operating system. Every time you touch something, it has these animations. I don't like animations. So what I do is I turn off all the animations. So the way to do that, you have to go to your settings. You want to scroll down and you have to enable developer's option. How you do that? You go to About Phone, you go to Software Information. Once you go to Software Information, you see what's called Build Number. You just click that about 5 or 6 times, and then you become a developer. Once you become a developer, you're going to see developer options going to be right at the bottom. All right, so when you see developer options at the bottom, open up developer's option and scroll until you see all the way down here, until you see Windows animation, transitions, and stuff like that. Turn them off. I turn it all off, right? So I won't get all that crazy animation and stuff like that. That makes the device a lot smoother than what it is. So once you do that, boom, you will see a huge change in how fast your device will run by turning off animations. It will make your device run a whole lot faster. Just turn it off. So another thing that you want to do when you get this device, remember, this is a $2,000 phone. Don't matter if you're paying it on payment plans. It don't matter if you bought it straight up. It's still a very expensive device. You want to turn on Find My Mobile. And the reason why is because if you lose it, or somebody stole it, or you just misplaced it, you can go to Samsung.com and you can trace and track where your phone at. So the way to do that, you want to go to security. All right, go to security and go to Find My Mobile. Now, I think at default, this is already toggled on if you logged into your Samsung account. And look, here's the thing. If you have a Samsung device, please make sure that you logged into a Samsung account. And the reason why is because you could do all your backup and restores and everything else from your Samsung account. If you don't have a Samsung account, go to your Samsung.com or create an account, or on your device, create a Samsung account. So when you lose your device or if you have any issues, you can always restore or backup on the Samsung account. So another trick that I want to emphasize is that you never know when you're going to get that special moment where you got to open up the camera. And if you have your layout and you can't find the camera app, sometimes it's very difficult to get that instant shot. Well, no fear. You can set your power button to click twice to open up the camera app. So right here, I click my power button twice and I'm ready for that video. I'm ready for that instant shot. The way to do this is that, again, let's go back into settings. You want to go to advanced features. Once you go into advanced features, you go to side key. Right here, quick launch camera by double pressing the power button right here. So another tip, and believe it or not, when I got this phone out of the box, this was already toggled on, and this is something that's very, very strange. I had never seen this toggled on a device. Maybe your device didn't have this, but my device did. It was set on a data roaming. When I looked at my my connections, and I went in my connections and my mobile networks, and I seen the toggle for data roaming was on. Now, if you travel and you go into certain areas where you don't have the good coverage or something like that, it's going to roam. If it roam, if you don't have roaming coverage on your contract through your carrier, they're going to charge you for data roaming. So me, I would suggest you guys turn it off. All right, so last but not least, something that is not toggled on out of the box is the edge screen, right? So right here, I have my edge screen, and this is important, especially if you want to do a lot of multitasking, right? So you open up an app right here. So I got Google open, and I swipe over here and just say I want to, you know, go to YouTube. So you click here, and now I got a pop-up window, and just say if I want to open up another app. Just say if I want to open up settings. I click here, and I go to settings. So now I got three apps open. This is important. So now at this point, I got YouTube open, I have my settings open, and I have google.com open. And this is important, especially if you want to do a lot of multitasking and stuff like that. So in order for you to get this, you have to enable this the edge screen. How you do that? Let's go ahead and get into it. So open up your settings again and go to your display. All right, when you go to your display, you scroll down until you see edge screen and turn it on, and you see edge lighting. That's pretty neat too, because if you get text messages or phone calls, your whole screen will light up, which is very nice. So turn the edge panels on, and then when you go to your edge panels, you can go down and add apps to it, what you want on your edge panel, if you want to do a lot of multitasking. So that's very important. It's something that I think is not toggled on out of the box. It's something that will help you with multitasking and stuff like that. This is Eric the Tech Preacher from Easy Computer Solutions. This is my 10 tips and tricks for you guys to make your device better. Now you can do this on any Android phone, but you know what? You got the shiny new device, go ahead on and make it happen, baby. This is the stuff that I do on all my phones. As soon as I take it out of the box, these are the settings that I set all my devices as soon as I get it out of the box. See you guys on the next video. Peace.